so much about each other.
Well, he'll talk your head off anyway.
I love it, because I love to talk. So. It's, no, we were in great company.
I bet you were. I love that necklace so much.
Thank you.
You don't mind this being recorded, do
you?
No! We're going to put videos on the website. So, we're gonna do videos of you and Stevens.
Perfect.
Something new that we're doing.
All right.
So makes it a little more interesting.
Yes, yes.
Oh, that's a good picture. Where'd you have that done
at? At my church. So this
really?
Picture, I think.
Wow. Oh, sorry. That's a good picture.
It looks like I'm thinking.
Thought pondering.
Yes.
Okay. So, so tell me why you're running for mayor.
I'm running for mayor of the city of Oliver because I believe I'm the leader that it takes to go to the next level. I'm looking forward to the opportunity to fight for a seat at the table. Together, you and I can accomplish this goal, a real representation that the city of Oliver has not seen in quite some time. I will assure the taxpayers that I will be working to make this city a better place to live, work, and play. I ask the citizens of Oliver to join me on this journey. This could be a dynamic place to live, work, and visit. We need to join forces. That's all of us, black, white, Hispanics, as residents of this city, and work together. I believe the residents and business owners in our city are the engines of our city. But the only thing with being the engine of the city, we need a better driver at the wheel.
So what do you think you can offer the city that Mayor Stevens doesn't or can't?
Well, I think in life, sometimes one has to realize when it's quitting time. I think Mayor Stevens has done as best that he can do, and I think it's time for him to realize that it's quitting time and time for new leadership. You know, nothing towards being negative about him, but I just believe that. And he also promised that he was not going to run this time, and I think we need to keep our promises that we give to the citizens.
So there's been a lot of talk on internet blogs and social media and some things come up in the community about whether this was going to be a race about issues or whether it was going to be a election about race or racial issues and racial divide. Is it going to be a race about issues, or is it going to be about a race of black and white thing?
Well, I don't know. I can't speak for anyone else. My race is about issues.
Okay.
It's not about race. We are all a part of the human race. So I think one thing that people need to put aside is not about color. It's about economics. It's about prioritizing. I believe it's about the four P's. Prioritize, promote, preserve, and protect. The taxpayers need to be updated on the processes that we are making in the city. They need to know what we're doing. Promote, businesses needs to be promoted. We need to promote and beautify our neighborhoods. We need to preserve our historical buildings. And we also need to protect our residents and our elderly and our environment from harm now and into the future.
So if you're elected mayor, would you make any changes to any of the department heads?
If elected mayor, I would not immediately make any changes. What I would like to do is to go in as a mayor, work with everybody, see what everybody's doing, be a fireman, fire chief for the day, be the police chief for the day, be the head of the sanitation, head of the water, because I would like to know what everybody is doing. Everybody's role is important. And as far as moving people, I think you need to know what they're doing, how affected they are, how affected they use tax dollars, which actually belongs to our citizens. So I would just like to kind of role play, work with everybody, even the secretaries, even the sanitation workers. Know what everybody is doing, what everybody's job is like. Because until you can understand and walk a mile in the person's shoes, you don't know what they're doing. And so I would like to spend some time with the senior citizens. And one of the things that I want to do, if I'm elected, for the first 6 months, I wanted to give my salary to some charitable organization or some less fortunate person, and I would like to do it by lottery. And that way, by increasing people coming to the meetings and just see what the city council meetings are all about, I would just definitely like to give, you know, like a lottery, put people's names that are needing funds for, let's say, electric bills, whatever it be. I would just like to donate it to several people. Give back. We need to start giving back to the citizens of this county. And it's not about anything, but we need to give the city back to the taxpayers. We really do. It is theirs. It is not ours. And I don't think we should act like we own it. It's not ours. We elected to represent the people of this district.
So would an organization or a person be required to attend the city council meetings in order to qualify for the lottery?
Absolutely. Okay. Unless they were unable. If they were unable, just say it was somebody that was bedridden, no, they would not.
So you mentioned that although it was, you know, you believe that there was a time for, you know, to know when your time is up, so to speak, with Mayor Stevens, and although he's done some good things, what do you think that the city has done right in the last couple of years?
Well, to be honest, I've been here for 26 years, and I'm really disappointed to a certain degree in what has happened in the city of Bolivar. We lost Harmon Automotive, and we've lost all of our businesses, even Western Downsize. And if we even go in the county, we lost Sequentia. When we had businesses in our community, we had little or no crime. When people are working, and actually, when people were working, I never heard of any gangs. People were not dealing drugs. People need jobs. So, you know, the only thing our kids have to look forward to is the two prisons that we have in Whitesville, and the criminal justice complex that costs millions of dollars and is falling apart. And So, I mean, and the schools, we need schools. Our schools are dilapidated. Our students are studying from old books. And I feel that the entire community is calling for a visionary that's going to make some positive changes. And I believe that my platform will solve a lot of these problems. If I'm elected, I pledge to go out and seek jobs, work with Southwest Development Agency and Corporation, work with the county, and make sure we go out and promote Bolivar. I also would like to work with the educational system, trying to initiate involvement with parents, involvement with teachers, and also just getting with the school board and the director of schools to see if they would put back into our schools general building trade. When we had general building trade, because everybody's not going to go to college. Everybody's not college material. A lot of kids that go to college the first year flunk out because they go because someone else wants them to go. Although we want all of our kids to be educated, but if you learn to build, you can make a decent living. Drafting should be in our school. Cosmetology should be put back in our school. We should have a computer programming program in our school that takes our kids from high school to directly into the workforce.
But to do that, that would come out of the county funds, and it would involve more teachers. Where would you get the money from?
Well, that's why I said I wanted to sit down and talk about some innovative ways to do this. I don't have all the answers now. I don't want anyone to think I have all the answers. That's why I said I would like to make a collaborative effort to sit down and talk about it. We need to talk and be more diverse, and I'll be able to talk. A lot of times the problems that we've had in our city and county is because we don't sit down and talk about our problems. We talk about them to others, and we don't go directly to the sources where we need to come together, brainstorm, have a think tank, where we can just sit down and dialogue. I think that's been one of the biggest problems of the cities, that it's been one segment here and another segment here. We have to come together as a diverse city and talk about our differences, talk about what we can do. And together, as we brainstorm, and another thing I would like to do if elected, I would like to have each council member bring two people as advisors from the community. Just not somebody that's been used to being on boards. Bring somebody in new. Bring a young person and an older person. Make it where we can have advisors, where we can have meetings. And I just would like to promote the city, but we have to do it together. We have to sit down, like I said, and brainstorm about what we want to do to make this city move forward. And I believe that we can do it. I really do. I was telling some people recently that the city has been going to the League of Cities recently, the last year. But they don't go there as I went there. When I went to the League of Cities, I attended all meetings. And I came back with information for the city. The first COP grant that the city of Bolivar ever had, I brought it back from the League of Cities. And also at the League of Cities, when I met Henry Cisneros, who was the housing director under President Clinton, I told him about Bolivar and the lack of adequate housing that we had. And I actually stopped him and he was walking with his bodyguards. And I said,